And welcome back to KTN News Desk, Michael Karanja. Now, about 2 weeks ago, you saw the president board a matatu all the way from State House and end up at KICC. And it was significant to some extent because that was the launch of a kind of national cashless system for transport. And in studio today, just to tell us about more about these cashless systems and how it's going to work starting from December, I am joined by Francis Major, who's the director at the National Transport and Safety Authority. Francis, if I was just to ask you, cashlight is something that we've had over the last few months. It was supposed to start sometime in June.
Yes.
Got delayed. But where are we in terms of a cashless transport system?
Thank you very much, Michael. And to begin with, there's a legal notice number 23 of 2014, which spelled out a number of regulations, policy regulations, in the way the PSV industry is to be operated. And one of the recommendations was cashlight. Cashlight is a professional word to use, but most people will say cashless.
Yeah.
So we are starting the implementation. There was a number of technical issues that needed to be resolved before we move forward. We are happy that this has now been done and we are good to go.
In terms of those technical challenges, I guess it strives for, right here I can see you have a card, which is a Beber Pay for KCB.
Yes, this is
but
just
what
one.
Was being launched was one by Safaricom. We also know that National Bank wants in it, Family Bank wants a card that they can use. So how are all these cards going to talk to one another, or are they going to be specific to certain buses?
Yeah, I think so far we have allowed six companies to operate this service. We have KCB operating a card called Pepea. We have Equity Bank.
Yeah.
We have Family Bank. We have Cooperative Bank. We have Safaricom. We have a company also called 1963 in partnership with Safaricom.
Yeah.
There is Mobile Pay or Tangaza.
Yeah.
So far, those are the people who have been allowed to operate, and they are good to go.
Yeah. But do the cars talk to one another? Because I assumed Beber Pay, one of the cars that were made, I think Abiria, was specific to KBS.
Yes.
So are the cards talking to one another as NTSA come up with a platform where you're able to use one card for different matatus?
Yeah, I think one of the issues that really we had to make sure that, actually there are a number of issues that we had to address. The first one was interoperability. That if I'm using, for instance, the Pepea card, it must be acceptable across all the people who are offering this service. So the terminal, any terminal that will be in any PSV vehicle must be able to accept these cards across broad. That has already been achieved, and it was one of the biggest issues. And these people have signed a memorandum of understanding that all their terminals, all their cards will be accepted, because there is a standard that we gazetted, the ISO standard 14443.
Yeah.
All the cards must conform to that standard. The other issue that we wanted to address is the issue of convenience, so that you don't have various terminals in various matatus. You go to a matatu, you have three or four terminals. So it is not convenient. The other issue we wanted is to deal with is the issue of settlement. After I tap my card and value has been moved from my card, at what stage does it hit the operator's account? The other issue is the issue of receipt. We needed to produce a receipt on every transaction so that there is evidence of payment. The other issue is security of the card itself. A number of players...
How secure are people's funds on
the
card?
Yes, how secure are they? And how secure is the card itself? The standards which were adapted was just to guarantee some of these things. And finally, the issue of availability.
Right.
Sometimes you can be an offline situation. Yeah. Maybe network is not available. That needs to be addressed.
All right. First, if I just ask you a two-pronged question as we just wind up. December 1st, we've already seen it being forwarded from June to December. How sure are we going to start in December? Then in terms of just the whole national transport issue, are you coming up with a policy that will be able to streamline this sector?
Yes, yes. Obviously, the December deadline is still there. We are happy now that most of the operators are already prepared. They've started issuing the terminals. They've started issuing the cards. And we'll be seeing a lot of activity going forward. My appeal to the public is that to avoid being inconvenienced, especially during the festive period, make sure that you have your card.
Yeah.
And to the PSV operators, I know this is a peak season for them. Make sure that you get these gadgets before the deadline comes. So that's the message we are sending. But in terms of the reforms in the industry, there's a lot more that we are trying to achieve by removing cash
from the system,
from the system itself.
All right.
Yes.
Thank you very much. That has been Francis Major, the director for the National Transport Safety Authority. He's telling us more about this cashless system that's supposed to kick out from the Monday, December 1st.